No idea what he wants, but something. He wants something. He wants to be an admin of the server. Picks first. I think Bullet picks first. So Bullet makes first pick. Bullet, first map. CT and DM3, as expected. Here we go. Okay, so the first game of this best of five is gonna be on CT and DM3. This is a well-known map. It's been ported in every single Quake. I think it's ported in Reflex as well, and probably more games. Probably like any FPS, fast FPS there is. So this map should be known to everyone. It was first created in Quake Worlds, and later ported to the other games. And hopefully the players will go ready here. The big difference between this map on this in this game is that the ready is always there, but the mega is here behind this little pillar instead of here, where you can find it in other games. But apart from that, the map is pretty much identical. You got the shaft here, some green armor there. That's not a yellow armor, by the way, in Quake World. It's a green armor. The yellow is not in the middle of the room here, but it's there in the corner. But it's pretty much the same in every game. This map is well known for being played a lot in the US and in Russia. In Europe, you don't play that much. We prefer like DM4 and Arrowwalk, and for some people prefer DM2 as well. But in Russia, they play a lot of CTN, and they do so in the US as well. And yeah, so predictions are, well, I think map wise we know that Bullet is gonna pick this one. I know that Lockjaw is probably gonna pick either DM2 or DM4, probably DM4 though, because that's been his style to pick that first the last couple of years. Bullet is probably gonna pick DM6 after that, and then Lockjaw goes with DM2 or DM4, whichever he chose first, whichever he didn't choose first. And the decider, if a decider, is probably gonna be on Arrowwalk. That's my guess, and I'm gonna say that Bullet is extremely dangerous on all the maps, especially CTN, but also on DM4. You know that Bullet Shaft, that extreme lightning gun that he's got, you don't wanna mess around with that. And DM4 is a great map for having a good shaft, so but Lockjaw is very experienced on that map, so that's gonna be hard for Bullet. But this game is, I'm gonna guess that Bullet wins this. Depends what shape he is in, or forma, as they would say. Bullet wants cam proxy. Okay, Lockjaw is gonna pet his cat. I don't know, these guys. So I'll take a sip of water while we wait. Comes the Russian. Yeah, so on DM2, yeah, I really hope to see a good game on DM2, because when Lockjaw and Bullet plays, you're gonna see such a big difference in playstyle. It's gonna show so much. You're gonna see Bullet backing off. If he gets the lead, he's gonna back off and he's gonna play a very defensive game, while Lockjaw is gonna chase him and play his offensive game. It's gonna be such a difference of playstyle. which is so interesting to see. I'm just gonna tab out so the stream will freeze a little bit. Okay, there we go. Also, if you find the stream laggy, you could always just try to lower the quality. Otherwise, it should be a Twitch problem. It's not me, anyways. I double checked. I did drop a few frames earlier today, but not anymore. Yeah, I'm sorry. There's not much to talk about while we wait. Apparently, Bullet is talking on the phone, and I don't know. But while we wait, we could always... We can take a look at the picture again, for anyone who missed it. This is a nice picture that BPS made for this finals. It shows pretty much their maps, and a little description of the players. Bullet, sneaky. Aim-heavy playstyle with good timings, and Loctar with the explosive playstyle delivering nice tricks, which pretty much explains them very well. Oh, I hear the game starting. Let's tab in. Here we go! Okay, I think we're on. 3, 2, 1. I'm gonna spectate Bullet in the start because this is his map. He's gonna get the yellow spawn. Loctar gets the better spawn though with the Mega and the red. So Bullet needs to play. Oh, he's actually gonna attack. He knows that Loctar has all the equipment that he needs, except for the shaft. Loctar is gonna attack, and he's gonna get the first frag. First frag goes to Loctar. I would question Bullet's attack a little bit, but, you know, first game, gotta feel each other out. Oh, nice frag by Loctar, expecting Bullet to go for the red there. Bullet is gonna spawn the lightning gun, so he's gonna have a weapon, but he's gonna die immediately. Loctar gets another frag. 3-0 for Loctar, not the start that Bullet would want. And he's gonna get the Mega, perfect timing, he's gonna get the red as well. Perfect control of Loctar thus far. And yeah, volume up, I can actually raise the volume a little bit. Let's try that. Perfect start for Loctar, he gets the yellow and he knows the red. Oh yeah, I don't get item timings as well on the stream when we are spectating like this. That's true. So bad start for Bullet, good start for Loctar. This is not Loctar's favorite map, so this is bad news for Bullet. Oh, that's a bad rocket jump. Bullet gets his first kill and gets himself on the board. He is gonna miss the red armor spawn though, and he's almost gonna kill himself. Looks a little shaky, Bullet does. He needs the yellow, he needs something. Because he's got no armor and he's not gonna win a fight against a stacked Loctar without any armor. He gets the yellow anyways, through some nice walking around the map. He's got shaft and he's got the rocket launcher. Red is up, he sees Loctar. Here comes the fight. Not gonna be enough to kill Loctar, but he should secure this red. Yeah, he does. You should also know that Mega should be up pretty soon if he damaged Loctar enough. Oh, good defensive play by Loctar, spamming those rockets. Bullet is having a hard time attacking. It's gonna get the yellow though, restack on the yellow, and red should be up, so... And there's the Mega. And there's the red, so Bullet in great shape now. So some uncharacteristic play by Loctar here, very defensive, but... In order to win a finals, you pretty much need to play defensive sometimes, but that's a nice attack and a spawn frag for Loctar. Loctar lagging a little bit, but that should be... It should be okay. Eats a rocket. He knows that Mega should be up anytime soon. There we go. So Loctar takes the map for himself once again, 7-1. Still a long time to go though, Bullet has all the time in the world. Octa can take damage here because he knows that the red is up. He can easily just rocket jump up to it and take it if it, should he take some damage. Octa still being a little bit cautious though. He knows that Bullet is very sneaky, so he could come, you know, attack anywhere. Oh, Bullet with the shaft. Octa not confident enough to keep that fight going. Oh, that should be a kill for Bullet. Nice play by Bullet, hitting the grenade. Mega should be up pretty soon for Bullet as well, so this could be Bullet's opportunity to take this game. Unless, of course, Lockjaw does a nice play again. Lockjaw is gonna back off, playing a little bit defensively, just escaping through the teleporter. Here's the fight. Oh, nice defensive play by Lockjaw once again. Bullet does hit a good shaft, but it's not enough. And Lockjaw is gonna pick up the red as well. Switching back to Lockjaw, see if he can get any spawn frags. This is perfect game one for Lockjaw. He did lose control once or twice, but didn't give away any frags whatsoever. No spawn frags, no nothing. Mega is up for him, and he takes it. And the reason you don't see any item timers is because I'm a regular spectator right now. I'm not on QTV, so those commands are disabled to prevent ghosting and such. Nice play from Lockjaw. Getting a lot of spawn frags here. Misses a rocket jump though, but it's not gonna hurt him too much. He knows the yellow is up, and the red should be up soon as well. He could go for that. Bullet kills himself. There's the red. He's damaged below 100, so he knows that he's got about 20 seconds until Mega spawns. Pretty much 10 right now. Oh, that's a dangerous attack, but it works out for Lockjaw. Okay, he's gonna miss the Mega, I think. But not the red, no. Oh, that's a nice grenade. Straight to the face. Okay, so Lockjaw is actually dominating this first game of the series. 18-1 with 4 minutes remaining. Mega is picked up by Bullet, I heard it. So it had been delayed a little bit, nobody picked it up. Red is up, Lockjaw is very weak though. Oh, and he kills him with the grenade. Jikes. Oh, some lag from Lockjaw, we don't like that. Here he goes for the red, and he picks it up, not really contested by Bullet, I don't know. Pretty weak start from Bullet. The best Pav Russia. Oh, that's a nice sneaky attack, and the perfect shot by Bullet. There you got to see how dangerous he is with the lightning gun. Oh, but Lockjaw just steals that yellow. From Bullet, I mean. Just steals it and gets the kill. Ah, I wish we had seen that frag from Bullet, his perfect lightning gun. Lockjaw is playing it safe, and I think he has to. I mean, he has a huge lead, 3 minutes remaining. I think this game is pretty much over. He could put on some show. He hasn't that just yet, though. Octa picks up the red. He should have timing on the Mega, so. But he's gonna go for the frag instead. Trying to find Bullet. Here's the attack. Oh, you see that? Octa is backing off. But he is gonna get the frag anyways. But you can see the respect that Octa has for that lightning gun. Bullet only needs like a second with that lightning gun to kill you. Oh, what a rocket by Lockjaw. He's gonna hit straight to the face of Bullet mid-air. Oh, he misses the rocket jump though, that's a problem. And he is gonna go down. Bullet needs the lightning gun, that's his saving grace. Oh well, good enough. Should get the Mega now. He's gonna go for the frags. Oh, but that's a nice shot by Lockjaw instead, and not a perfect attack by Bullet. He's gonna get the red though. But Lockjaw gets the mega and the perfect shot from Lockjaw. I'm gonna switch over to Lockjaw. You need to remember that even though Bullet has this insane lightning gun, one of the most insane lightning guns, Lockjaw is on such a level that he's got a very solid lightning gun as well. So you can't solely rely on that LG to win a game. Since the other top players also have very good lightning guns. Looking a little bit shaky, but he does get the frag. Bullet does, and he gets the red as well, but he's got no time. No time to bring this back. 26 to 9. 45 seconds remaining. I mean, I don't know about this game. Lockjaw did get the better start. He did get everything he needed. And he got a few frags, a few spawn frags. Even though Bullet did take the control back, it wasn't enough to really turn the game around as Lockjaw managed to kill him, and then it was his turn to get some frags once again. So, I don't know. I'm sure that Bullet is not happy about this game. He's gonna get a few frags here, maybe to help him in the next game. This is a best of five, so even if he loses this, shouldn't be a big issue. I wonder what map Lockjaw is gonna pick though. I would love to see DM2. I would love to see DM2. Anyways, 26 to 15 is the final score. People asking if they can join the server. I don't think you can. I think the server is full. But you could always try. It's on some Russian server. You can find it. Lockjaw is gonna pick DM4, which is too bad if you ask me, but I guess DM4 is a good map as well. I'm gonna start by specking Lockjaw. Here we go. Second game. DM4. This is a well-known Quake World map. I don't think it's been ported very well to any other Quake, but it's very popular in Quake World. It's very small, and you know, it's like constant fighting on this map. It centers around this lightning gun in the middle of the big room, which is so important. If you have control of that, you could potentially win every game, like if you kept control of that. But against these good players, they need to go for armors and so on. That was the red armor room. Bullet did get the red armor spawn. Oh, that's a nice attack by Bullet. He's gonna get the frag. Is he gonna get the conversion? Yes, he is. Maybe another one? No. Red should be spawning soon. Oh, Lockjaw tries for the attack, but doesn't work out for him. Okay, and Lockjaw goes for the lightning gun. So Bullet gets the red. Only 5 cells left. So he needs to pick up some cells to be able to lightning gun him to death, which he likes to do. Only 1 rocket as well. He's very low on ammo. He needs that pack from Lockjaw. Should he kill him? Lockjaw is gonna play defensively. He's gonna play sneaky. He's gonna try to trick Bullet somehow into making a mistake. Methodical play by Lockjaw, but it's not gonna be enough. Bullet is gonna get the kill, but Lockjaw gets the red armor. That's a problem for Bullet because he's low on armor, and that's a good first rocket from Lockjaw. He's gonna attack, but that's a good shot by Bullet, at least enough to kill Lockjaw. Oh, what a telefrag from Lockjaw! That's so Lockjaw. He waits for just a split second because he knows that Bullet is gonna take that path, and it's enough to that small delay from taking the teleporter is enough to wait for Bullet to enter the zone, the death zone, the teleporter spot, and then Lockjaw telefrags him. Perfect, perfect telefrag by Lockjaw, and that gives him the control of the game. Here we go. Lockjaw, he still needs to hunt for frags though. He's down 1 frag, and Bullet is gonna wait here. He's gonna camp. Oh, it's not enough. Lockjaw gets the frag, but Bullet with the counterattack when he spawns with the lightning gun. Bullet back in the lead, and this time he's got control. Perfect turnaround from Bullet. He could go for the armors. And I think he is now. He's just gonna deny Loktar this lightning gun. He does not want. Oh, whoa. Don't miss that jump. You don't wanna fall down into the lava. Loktar wins the fight with just a super shotgun. How did that happen? I think Bula should have gone for the armors. He does get a couple of frags though, and he gets the armor. So Bula is in great shape now. Nice play by Loktar though. Getting the kill with the super shotgun. What? Anyways, Bulat's in control. He knows that Loktar is in the super shotgun room. He wants to deny Loktar from getting the LG. The LG is so important on this map that that's why he's just standing here. He does not want Loktar to sneak out and get the lightning gun. That's the pretty much only way he should. Oh, he's actually found himself a pack. So he did have the lightning gun. Bullet did not know that. At least I didn't. I don't think he did either. Oh, Bullet a little bit lucky. Gets shot up onto the ledge. Wow, Bullet is playing well now. 8-4. This is Loktar's pick. And the problem with spawning where Loktar is now is that that's the mega room, so you can get the mega and you can get a rocket launcher and a lot of ammo for the rocket launcher, but there's only one escape. There's only one way to get out of there. Bullet's playing it safe, going for the armors, but that gives the LG to Loktar. So Loktar has got the lightning gun and the rocket launcher and potentially the mega. And Bullet has no rockets whatsoever. It's possible. It's very possible with his Russian defensive style that he's just gonna wait here. Wait here for Loktar to come attack him. Because he's got no rockets. He can't do much from here. Oh, he tries to escape but gets shot down into the lava. That's DM4 for you. Loktar has got no armor. But he is gonna deny the LG. He's gonna hunt for more frags. I guess he needs to. 5 minutes remaining and 3 frags down. He gets the yellow and he's gonna... Well, Bullet runs into the mega room. Probably gonna stay there, so Loktar should stack up on armor. Probably get the red. I think he's gonna too. Gonna do that. Or he's gonna do some crazy rocket thing and attack. You never know with Loktar, that's the thing. There's the fake rocket jump. I don't even think that Bullet heard that one. It's not enough to fake him out. He needs to attack, and he tries to. It is gonna be enough. Oh, with a lucky spawn as well. Loktar gets... Oh, but he gets killed! Oh, no! That's such a rookie mistake. You should always wait for that rocket to hit before you enter the teleporter. And Loktar did not do that. That's a rookie mistake. And that gives Bullet the frag. Bullet is back in control all because of that. Oh, Bullet down to very low HP. Is he gonna die to the boomstick? No, he's not gonna die to the boomstick yet again. Not this time. Once again, Bullet is in here. Oh, is he gonna shock everyone and attack? Oh, this could be dangerous for Loktar. No. He read Bullet like a book. He knew that he was gonna come. Oh, that grenade, you need to dodge that, Bullet. Eat some spam. Not enough to bring him down. This time, he doesn't fall down into the lava. This is good news for Bullet. He's got way, way more armor than Loktar does. And that gives him the frag as well. Loktar is gonna get the red spawn, though. This could be dangerous for Bullet. Oh yeah, Loktar is gonna get the pick off, I mean. But he's in a problematic situation here. He's got no armor, no health, no nothing. And that's gonna kill him. By switching over to Bullet once again, you can see in the lower part of the screen who I'm spectating, if someone did not know that. Oh, nice attack by Loktar. Is it gonna be enough, though? I mean, he's got 7 frags to catch up. 2 minutes. I guess it's possible. Of course it is. Oh, that's a nice rocket. Oh, Loctar, I mean, Bullet is even slow spawning. He knows that this is close. Fire frags. Loctar is gonna pick up the red now and then attack Mega most likely. Here he goes. Bullet falls down into the lava. This is problematic for him. Loctar is down to just 20 HP though, so he needs to back off. That's gonna save Bullet a few seconds. Ah, oh, Loctar really needed that frag. Oh, and here's the attack. He's gonna get the frag, but he's very, very low. That's a yellow armor for Bullet. He needs to keep attacking. 4 frags! 1 minute and 20 seconds. This is gonna get close. Bullet is counting it's close though. He can't play defensive too long. At least not against Loctar. Oh, he gets the frag with... Oh, and he the spawn frag as well. 2 frags. 1 minute. Oh, and another frag. This is looking like Bullet was trying to play defensive a little bit too early. Here comes the frag. 14 to 14. Oh, but Bullet gets the frag and the spawn frag. Yeah, he does. Wow. Okay, so Bullet is in the better spot right now. And he could wait here once again. He only has 29 HP, so exiting this teleporter is very dangerous. He's got full armor, but not enough health. He does have plenty of ammo, though. Oh, he's gonna try to escape even that low HP. 20 seconds. This is gonna be close. Loctar needs to attack, and so he does, but he is gonna die. And the spawn frag for Bullet. That should be the game. I don't see Loctar bringing this back. Nice play by Bullet. And a little bit of a lucky spawn to change everything in the end. I was so sure that Loctar was gonna win that. But no, he isn't. 19 to 14. Okay, so that means... Bullet needs to pick this map. I'm not sure if he chose Arrowwalk or... No, he's gonna go with DM6. Okay, so DM6. This map is one of my... Definitely not my favorite map. One of the worst maps I know. Anyways, here we go. Loctar, Bullet spawning next to each other. Loctar is gonna opt to go for the Mega and the green armor. No shaft for him just yet though. Oh, Bullet with the aggressive play. Going for the lightning gun. This is dangerous for Loctar. Oh, he escapes with 8 HP. Just 3 rockets though. Oh, nice rocket. It's a nice, very nice rocket by Loctar. Oh, but the backstab from Bullet. And the aggressive play. He knows the Mega should be up very soon. There we go. There's the Mega. So he's gonna go back to the red room, most likely. Make sure that Loctar does not get the red. He's even gonna attack. Nice play by Bullet with a rocket jump and the attack. He should go back and grab the red armor now, though. Save it up. Gonna pick up some cells. More ammo for his lightning gun. Still not going for the red. He doesn't want Loctar to get the lightning gun. He's gonna wait until the hatch closes. And then go for the red. Very smart play by Bullet. Very experienced. Very calm. This is gonna be so hard for Loctar. One thing about this map that is so hard is to turn a game around. It's almost impossible against a very good player to turn this game around. Turn this map around, which is why I don't particularly like it. But I mean, the level of play is all that matters. And oh, that's so ballsy by Bullet. He actually enters the teleporter that could as well have been a kill for Loctar, but he takes the gamble and he enters and he gets the frags. A nice play by Bullet, but very, very daring, very brave play. actually, thinking about it, that could have even led Lockter, you know, if Lockter got that frag, he would have gotten momentum and could probably turn this around in an instant. That's not gonna happen though, since Blood got the frag. So this is a safe spot that Bullet is standing at right here at the GL. You can just stand here, easily get the red if you need, and you can deny the lightning gun in the hatch down at the floor, and you can pretty much see every escape that Lockter could potentially take. That is why I really don't like this map. Like, you can just stand there and control every single important thing on this map, except the Mega. But since Bullet already has the Mega, it's not gonna spawn, and Bullet is gonna have the perfect timing on it. So it's gonna be so easy for him to just drop down into the pipe and go get the Mega whenever he knows that it's gonna spawn. So pretty much in 20 seconds from now, it's gonna spawn. So look for him in 15 seconds to go to the Mega Room. He's gonna get the red now at 50. And then he's gonna go back, and now he's gonna enter the Mega Room. Watch this. He's gonna do it, and he's gonna get the Mega for free, probably. Lockter shouldn't be able to go here at all. Now the Mega spawns in 2, 1, there we go. Perfect play by Bullet. But this is Lockter's opportunity. He knows that the red should spawn in 1 second, and he gets it. So Lockter has the red now. He doesn't have a shaft, I don't think. But at least he has got armor. Some sneaky play from Bullet and Lockter. Lockter needs to play very sneaky to be able to do something in this game. So the red is up and Bullet is gonna rocket jump to it and take it. Lockter needs to back off. Probably doesn't have too much armor left anyways. The one thing that Bullet does not have access to, and that's important on this map, is more ammo for his rocket launcher or grenade launcher. Since in Quake World, GL and RL use the same ammo. You run out of them very fast. You run out of rockets very fast. And the only rocket spawn where you can get more rockets is in the green area. And so that's something that Bullet is gonna miss out on. He's not gonna have more rocket ammo unless he tries to attack. But I don't think he has to. I mean, lightning gun is more than enough to secure everything. Anyways, Mega is gonna be up soon. So Bullet should be attacking that area very soon to get the Mega. Oh, the red should spawn any second. Oh, Lockter was so close to getting it. Not close enough though. This leads me to believe if Bullet should win this game, which it very much looks like, we should get to see a DM2, and I'm so excited about that. I love DM2 between these two players. I'm hoping for a good game. Oh, nice shaft by Bullet. Keep him nailed in the air. 4 minutes, 30 seconds remaining. This is gonna be very harsh for Lockter. He's gonna open the hatch to the LG, but as it looks now, he's never gonna be able to enter that. Bullet has way too good control to let that happen. Does fall down though! Oh, this is Lockter's chance! Can he hit the rockets? He needs to hit this rocket! He does, but he does die as well. But oh, Lockter gets the pack though. Yeah, he does get the LG, so I'm gonna watch Lockter. He needs to chase. He needs to get some frags now. 9 frags in 4 minutes, definitely doable. Definitely doable. Gets the Mega, he's perfectly stacked now. He's gonna rocket jump, here comes the Lockter tricks. Lockter moves. Ooh, nice. Nice LG to the back of Bullet. Not enough to kill him though. Oh, that's a risky play. Remember the teleporters? It's so easy to get telefragged. Oh, misses a rocket jump. It's so easy to get telefragged when you do that. So it's so risky, but you know Lockter, he's a gambler, he's gonna do it. He's not afraid of anything. Oh, somehow Bullet did get the lightning gun though. I'm not sure how that happened. Oh, here's the fight, and Lockter is gonna get it. He should get this red as well. 8 frags now, 3 minutes. If I know Bullet right, he's just gonna try to defend and run away. But Loctar is gonna chase, so I'm gonna keep watching Loctar just because he is in such a bad position. He's gonna play the sneaky game. See if he can find Bullet. There he is. Not enough to kill him though. Bullet gets the Mega, I heard it, and Loctar is attacking! Oh, what a nice teleporter play! Confusing Bullet. So that's 7 frags. That's 6 frags. Definitely doable. Bullet needs to slow this game down, because if Bullet does not, he may as well lose this. That's a nice fake jump by Loctar. Faking the sound as if he jumped down to the floor, but he did not. This time he did though, but he goes for the red. What a rocket from Bullet! What? What? Are you kidding me? Well, Loctar is gonna get the frag though. But that was a sick rocket by Bullet. No idea how that hit. Straight to the face of Loctar. Loctar only with the green armor now though, but the red is up and he's gonna get that. 5 frags, 1.5 minutes. If Bullet plays this correctly, he should be able to close this game out, but he's gonna slow spawn. 4 frags, 1.5 minutes. Oh, Loctar is gonna go for the attack. This is exciting, guys. Is Loctar gonna be able to do it? I don't know. It's easy to play defensive on this map. Oh, he's actually going for the lightning on. That's a risky play from Bullet. Very uncharacteristic, and he's gonna die for it. 3 frags, 1 minute. This. Oh, but the defensive play from Bullet. Oh, but he dies again from Loctar's boomstick. What? Okay, so we're back in Loctar's favor once again. Not score-wise, but position-wise on the map. He's gonna get the lightning gun as well. 40 seconds, 3 frags. Good timing on the Mega from Loctar. But he needs to make something happen now. 30 seconds, Bullet gets the red. Oh, and Loctar dies. That should be the game. I'm switching over to Bullet. That should be the game. Unless Loctar makes some crazy play here. He's gonna play the teleporter game that he's so good at, but it's not gonna be enough. Ah, that was so close for Loctar, but good play from Bullet, good defensive play, and he actually got the red in the last second when Loctar returned to the red room. Little mistiming on Loctar's behalf, but, well, 13-8, that's a good game. 2-1 to Bullet, 2-1. Fourth game is gonna be, fourth map, I mean, is gonna be Loctar's pick, so let's see DM2 now, come on. No, why? Why Airwalk? Why? Oh my god. Oh well. Here we go, Airwalk. This has also been ported to every major FPS out there. Except for these, you know, realistic ones. Okay, Bullet gets the Mega Spawn and the yellow, but he's not gonna get the red. That's gonna go to Loctar as well as the Lightning Gun. Here comes the fight. Loctar, ooh, almost kills Bullet. One of Loctar's best friends, BPS, is very well known to be one of the best players in the world on this map. So Loctar has been forced to play this map a lot, but it hasn't really become a favorite of his, even though he's played it a lot by now. Good control of the Mega by Loctar. Oh, but he eats some spam. And... oh well, Loctar is gonna lose that fight. I really wonder why did Loctar not pick DM2? Because if Bullet wins this game, Bullet is well known to be very good on this map. If Loctar loses this game, we're going to a second best of 5. As Bullet is coming from the lower bracket. So we might see more Quake, guys! Of course, we don't mind that. Good start for Bullet anyway, 3-0. Wow, it's so hot in Sweden, by the way. The last couple of days have been crazy. Blood is waiting for the Mega. Oh, that's a dangerous attack by Loctar. Perfect situation for Blood to use his crazy shaft, but oh, cutting it close there. Very close. Should get the red for free though. And some health. This map has so many health packs on it. Like, it's so easy to restack on health if you lose some. There's the Mega. Perfect timing for Bullet. Perfect control. 5-0 after like 2 minutes. Good play by Bullet overall. But I still want to criticize. Oh, that's a nice rocket, but it's not going to be enough to kill Bullet. But that is, though. So let's switch to Loctar. He's going to get the red. I was saying, I still want to criticize Loctar for this map pick. He knows how good Bullet is on this map. Maybe he's afraid of the small packet loss that he's got. That if you play DM2, he might get some, you know, miss some sounds or something. Oh, he misses the rocket jump to the red armor. That's devastating. Oh, but Bullet was too weak to go for it, so it's still gonna be there for Loctar. Some sneaky play. Oh, but Bullet knew about that. Oh, he gets the Mega as well. Perfect frag by Bullet. Oh, the Mega steal. That's demoralizing for Loctar. Loctar gets the red spawn, but he's just gonna die anyway to Bullet's shaft. Like that lightning gun. You're not gonna survive that. Oh, well, they trade frags. Not too bad for Loctar, but the better spawn for Bullet. No cells left, though, so Loctar should be able to get that frag. No! Bullet gets the rocket launcher in that pack. Oh, Bullet barely just survives. Loctar gets all the armors, though. But Bullet is dealing so much damage to Loctar. Even though Loctar did get both the armors, Bullet still got the frag. Nice spam. Oh, but he kills himself. What just happened? Red armor goes to Loctar and the frag as well. So 12-6 for Bullet. Switching over to Loctar, he still needs to get at least 6 more frags to tie this game. Gets the Mega. Oh, nice attack. Perfect shaft, perfect attack. Nothing to do differently. It was perfect. 5 minutes remaining, 4 frags down. This is definitely doable for Loctar. And should Loctar win this, I should say, then we're definitely going to see Team 2, as it's the last map remaining in the pool. So at least if Loctar wins it, we are gonna see DM2. I can't wait. I want to see DM2, guys. Okay, so the break goes to Bullet. Loctar not really wanting to attack there. He does have the Mega and the Yellow, though, which is slightly better than just having the red. Mega and Yellow is better than red. Oh, what a nice grenade right after he left the teleporter. That's a nice grenade. Perfect play from Loctar. Very sneaky, very nice. So 2 frags. Should definitely be doable. This should be a frag. No. He's gonna rocket jump. Opt for control of the map instead of the kill. Should he have killed Bullet there? He might lose control of the map depending on where Bullet spawns. Red should spawn now, so Loctar is still in good shape. Next item to spawn is the Mega. Oh, Loctar lagging a bit. I don't like to see that. We don't want any lag to causing trouble in this game. Oh, he gets the Mega, though. Wow. 1 frag, anyways. gets the yellow. Bullet does get the red though, so that's good for Bullet. He does have a chance now to kill Loctor. He's got everything he needs. Loctor is in a bad spot. He's low on both armor and health. He needs this red. He just has to stay here, yeah. There's the red. The Mega is up, Loctor is... Ooh, he barely just kills Bullet. That was so close. Loctor picks up the Mega and the kill. 12-12. Tie game, 3 minutes remaining. He's gonna get the red as well. He should. So Loctor is in good shape to close out this game. Just needs a couple of spawn frags though. He hasn't gotten many. This might be one. Yes. Gets the yellow as well. This should be another one, and red should spawn any second now. So this is good for Loctor, very good for Loctor. There we go. 2 minutes remaining, 3 frags. Bullet needs to do something to get back into this game. He needs to do that soon. Mega as well for Loctor. Good play. I'm starting to see why he picked Arawak, but I really, really wonder how... when he started valuing, you know, Arawak above DM2. But I guess it was just a gut feeling surprising Bullet that way. I'm sure Bullet was surprised as well by the pick. Four frags up. Oh, that's important for Bullet. If he could get this red, that's his chance to turn this series around. There's the red, so Bullet... not this series, of course, I mean the game. Sorry. 1 minute and 10 seconds remaining, 3 frags up. Come on, Bullet, you can do it. Oh, the rockets are good from Loctor. Not enough to kill Bullet, though. Bullet should get the next red as well, but he's running out of time. 50 seconds remaining. He still needs to get 3 frags. Perfect defensive play by Loctor. I'm not sure this is gonna be enough. 45 seconds. 3 frags. Oh, there's the frag! 2 frags. Should get this Mega. He should get the red if he attacks. Maybe he's not going to. No, Loctor is gonna get it. Perfect first rocket though from Bullet. Gets the yellow as well. 25 seconds, 2 frags. Loctor is just trying to run away. Gets a nice rocket onto Bullet. This is gonna be enough to stop him though, I don't think. Oh, Bullet thinks he's up there, but he's not, he's going for the yellow. That, you're running out of time, Bullet, you need to attack. No, it's not gonna be enough. It's not. 2 seconds remaining. Loctor is gonna win this map. 16-14. That gets us to 2-2. A tied series, and we're going to a decider game of this first best of 5. Should Loctor win it, he's gonna be the champion of this edition of Thunderdome. If Bullet wins it, we're going to another best of 5. So the decider of this one is gonna be on DM2. I am so excited about this. I love seeing DM2 between these two guys, these two players. Oh, okay. Seems that the players are taking a little bit of a breather. Bullet is ready though, he wants blood. He's not happy about that Arawak loss. I don't know. Like, I was so surprised to see Loctor pick Arawak. And then he goes and wins the game? No idea. Anyways, here we go. The deciding game of the first best of one. Best of five, sorry. But this is effectively a best of one now. What? With the slow spawn, he's gonna get... Oh, what? What? Are you kidding me? So he takes a lava bath. But he still gets the mega and the red. Oh, we're gonna see an attack from Loctar. Bullet is running away. He does not want to give the first frag to Loctar. Loctar is chasing. This is the Russian playstyle. He's gonna back off all the time if he can. He's gonna hope that Loctar just pressures him and, like, you know, attacks him. Attacks into. Wow, is he gonna stand here already? The score is 0-0. No, he's gonna exit. I thought he was gonna start standing there, even though he hasn't even gotten a frag yet. But he's not gonna. Here comes the first fight. Oh, nice grenade by Loctar. It's not enough to bring Bullet down, though, and he's gonna back off. Oh, dodging a few rockets. Oh, and Loctar gets the frag. Very nice frag. All the way from this area. Nice. So that's Loctar in the lead. Yeah, this map is special because it's got two red armors. One spawns here in this area, and the other one in the secret area, where Bullet just died. That's very different from other maps. This is actually the very first map that was made in Quake 1. This is like before they added the lightning gun, which is why it doesn't have a lightning gun. Because this map was created before the lightning gun. So that's interesting. Oh, Bullet is trapped up there. Loctar is gonna spamming down. Oh, he gets the first rocket, but Bullet with a perfect comeback, but it's not enough. Loctar is just way too tanky. There's the second red armor, as I was talking about. Nice. Nice rocket from Bullet. Not enough to kill, of course. Loctar is gonna back off with some rocket jumps. A lot of rocket jumps, even. Picking up health packs and then wasting them. But he knows the red is... the mega is up there, but he's not gonna be able to go for it just yet. He needs a red armor, at least. He's going for this red, yeah? Is he going for the back room as well? I don't know. I think he is. He does have the lead, though, so he doesn't need to attack or anything. He could just wait here. And he is gonna... I think? Yeah. He is gonna wait here. Let's switch over to Bullet, see what he's doing. Okay, so he's gonna take the second Mega. So he's gonna be as stacked as you can be in Quake World. He's gonna have 200 armor and pretty much 250 health. You can't get more tanky than this. And then he's gonna try to attack. Two rockets from Loctar. It's gonna force Bullet to back off. Get this red and then probably try again. He still has both the Mega, so no Mega is gonna spawn for Loctar. Loctar sees him. Oh, and he takes another lava bath and he gets shot down into the lava once again. Oh, and he dies! A grenade and the rocket launcher at the same time. A rocket and a grenade hits him. That's gonna bring him down. Perfect defensive play from Loctar, but I don't know. I'm not sure. I'm so sure about that attack. Maybe he should do as Loctar always does and start gathering nails. Because there's a nail pack over there that you don't want to pick that up, because that gives away your position. Oh, he takes another lava bath. What is Bullet doing? No. Jesus. And he's got no health. He's never going to win that fight. 4-0 for Loctar. Bullet remembered that there's a rocket pack there, so he goes and picks it up. Oh, Loctar is chasing. He really doesn't have to do that, of course, but you know, if you feel that you can get the frag, you can always, you know, chase to get a bigger lead, you know, once ahead, get further ahead. But, you know, not all players are like that, but that would explain why Loctar constantly tries to attack, even though he already has the lead. Oh, Loctar is gonna have to be careful, I was gonna say, but apparently no. Good play from Loktar. Bullet does not hit the rockets that he needs to hit. He could get this red though, but you know, 5-0, 5 minutes remaining. Bullet is in a bad spot, very bad spot. Oh, he does win this fight though. That's his opportunity to. He doesn't have much armor though. Oh, he gets the frag. Okay, so Bullet could potentially be back into this game now. 2-5. He does get the red. He knows that the Megas are gonna spawn, so he needs to get them and then find Loktar. Start putting on pressure. This is not Bullet's comfort zone though. You know, Bullet wants to be the one in the lead and then back off and, you know, play defensively. He does not want to be the chaser. Loktar is gonna take a very defensive road to this game now. Oh, nice defensive play by Loktar and the spawn frag as well. And some rocket jumps. That's the Loktar we're used to. It's so hard to attack where Bullet did there around the quad area. Oh, Loktar almost dying. It's not enough though. Does get the red. Oh, he's gonna attack with a rocket jump. Some fancy play here from Loktar. Another one, and he gets the frag as well. And another one. And maybe a third. No, he's not. Okay, so he dies to the buckshot. The super shotgun. The double barrel monster shotgun. Here comes the rocket jump again. He's fancy, we know it, but he's gonna die though. Bullet, I'm gonna switch over to him. No, actually, I'm gonna stay on Loktar because I have this feeling that Loktar is gonna do something crazy. He's got the lead, 5 frags, 2.5 minutes to go. Okay, so he's gonna stand here for now, but I think that, just wait for it, he's gonna do some attack that we're not expecting him to do. Because he's Loktar, he does those stupid things. Okay, is this gonna be the fight? Yeah, Bullet does engage. Oh, perfect start for Bullet. But Loktar turns it around a little bit, but no, he's gonna die to the buckshot. Maybe gets a spawn frag here. Oh, they kill each other. I mean, Bullet kills himself. He just blasts that rocket into Loktar's face, but he dies so himself. And then he dies once again. Loktar fails a rocket jump. Oh, this is a fancy jump. Oh, he misses it though. That's so hard to do. I always try, but I always fail. So here we go. Gonna wait for the red here. 1 minute 40 seconds remaining. Bullet needs to chase. And like I said, that's not his comfort zone. Loktar, on the other hand, this is not his comfort zone either. But this also gives him room to try different things and still be able to, you know, win the game, potentially. Bullet does get the frag though. Now he needs to chase though. 4 frags is a lot on DM4. It's a lot on DM4. That's why I think Loktar is playing a little bit, you know, careless and a little bit reckless. Just because he knows that if he wants to, if he needs to, he can probably back off and secure this game. But we've seen crazy things happen on this map. We saw a game between UL and Rekby, where Rekby got like, I don't know, 12, 13 spawn frags on this map. So you never know what could happen. But Loktar is gonna kill Bullet again. That's gonna give him a 7-frag lead. With 40 seconds remaining of the game, there's no way in hell Bullet turns this around. So I'm just gonna stay on Loktar now. Oh, what a frag. What an exchange of frags even.